guys. Welcome to the Thanksgiving edition of Apache News. I'm Kristen Yamashiro.
And I'm Brittany Liu. We have plenty of info, so mark your calendars and let's get started.
Attention all NHS members. There is a mandatory meeting today at lunch in the lecture hall. If you do not attend the meetings and events, you cannot remain a member in good standing. Find all NHS information at the Fusion page on nhs.ahs.ausd.net for announcements, calendars, news, events, and files.
Are you interested in supporting the White Mountain Apaches? Well, here's Amy for more on SCAC's annual money drive.
Hey you. Yeah you. See those buckets in your fourth period classroom? Well, you can donate to the Apache Drive today. If you guys raise $75, you'll get a donut party. And if you guys raise $100, you'll get a pizza party. Remember, today is the last day to donate, so please support the White Mountain Apache Tribe in Arizona. This has been Amy Leong reporting for Apache News. Back to you guys in the studio.
Thanks, Amy. I know I'll donate. On a related note, if you're looking to earn $100,000 for Arcady High School, sign up for Spreebird.com. You'll get great deals on entertainment, food, activities, and all you have to do is sign up at Spreebird.com/100K giveaway and stay subscribed for at least 60 days. With your help, AHS can earn up to $100,000, so please support.
Attention all potential CSF members. Today is the last day to turn in your $5 membership dues. They must be returned no later than 3 p.m. to the ASB office, and you must have your ID card with you. Failure to pay your dues will result in disqualification from membership for spring semester 2011.
Attention all sophomores. The sophomore class will be having their first spawning event today at the rally court after school. It's an ice cream social, so don't forget to bring your ID cards.
The PowerSchool student portal is now activated so that you can access your grades online. Just go to powerschool.aosd.net and use your ID number as username and your password, which is the same as your network login.
Wondering what you could do to help others on Thanksgiving? Well, here's Rachel to give you some ideas.
It's that time of the year again, Thanksgiving. A time to show our gratitude to all the people we love and the things we have. But are you interested in taking it one step further by helping other families in need? Well, the Foothill Unity Center has plenty of opportunities to help out.
Oh, for so many years we have helped those that are really in need and in crisis in the San Gabriel Valley. We're doing huge holiday Thanksgiving food boxes for our families in need. And it's looking like we're going to have a good 1,500 families that are going to be coming over to the Arboretum for a traditional Thanksgiving food box. There's many ways you can volunteer, not only for Thanksgiving, but for the holidays and all year round. Here's sorting, helping with our paperwork as well. And then on Saturday, we will be packing all of those food boxes at the LA County Arboretum. Then on Monday and Tuesday, we will be giving them out to our families. So you need volunteers on there too to help give it out.
I hope you are all inspired by the Foothill Unity Center's efforts and you get out there and do your part. This has been Rachel Gasparini, back to you in the studio.
Well, do you love to travel? Do you want to experience other cultures? If so, come to the Career Center to pick up a flyer to see what non-AUC sponsored trips are available during spring break and summer vacation.
Freshman Council will be hosting their first bonding event on Friday, December 2nd from 3 to 5 p.m. under the pavilion with hot dogs and s'mores. Tickets will be sold for only $1 from November 28th to December 2nd from any Freshman Council member at lunch and in rooms J23 and J24. Your ticket will be entered for a chance to win gift cards. Don't forget to come with your friends and to have a great time with your class of 2015 peers.
Did you forget to buy a birthday present for your friend? Well, ASB has got you covered. You can now buy a birthday gram for only $5 at the ASB office. They come with balloon, a card, and a personalized birthday song that will be delivered.
Are you curious to see how you can be charitable this holiday season? Well, here's Hazel on more about the White Christmas Drive.
Hey guys, it's time for Arcady High School's annual White Christmas Drive.
White Christmas is a food drive to benefit those in Arcadia who don't have enough food to eat during Christmas time. A group of students who were malnourished were noticed by a group of Holly Ave teachers in 1932. So the teachers asked students to gather some cans and they wrapped them in white tissue paper and gave it to them for Christmas.
Make sure it's foods that you want to eat and that you enjoy eating and that they're in cans. Nothing in glassware, no perishable items, and nothing home-baked.
We'll be collecting during your fourth period classes, so bring in as many cans as possible.
The drive will start November 28th and end on December 2nd, so go collect cans during your Thanksgiving break and bring them in when you come back from school. I expect lots of cans this year, guys.
Do you like snakes? Do you want to see them up close and personal? Well, you're in luck. Stop by during lunch or after school today outside the lecture hall near the S building to see a collection of venomous reptiles.
You should sign up for Acadia High School's Peer Tutoring Outreach Division. Students in the program tutor the middle school students at First Ave on Mondays and Wednesdays and Dana on Tuesdays. Applications can be found online at students.ausd.net/ahstutors/apply and return to H8. For more information, email ahs.outreach@gmail.com.
Hey gamers! Dragons are roaming the world of Skyrim, so here's Tim Kong for this week's game review.
Hey gamers, Tim here with another awesome game review of Skyrim, the newest entry in the Elder Scrolls saga. The game so far is astonishing, and the graphics have improved tremendously from the previous game, Oblivion. The characters have evolved from having cartoon-like faces to a more realistic look, allowing players to show their personality through their characters. From the puffy clouds and pristine sky to the rushing water in the crystal rivers, the artists of Skyrim have made incredible enhancements to the game's aesthetics. I've played this game nonstop since I picked it up on Friday, and I know for sure that I barely even scratched the surface. There are over 300 life-sucking hours that can be played in Skyrim, so make sure you don't go crazy playing this game, because I already learned my lesson the hard way.
The incredible dragon fights are executed perfectly. The blazing fire from the beasts and the powerful roars are shocking. If you ever wanted to know what it would be like to slay one of these mythical beasts, Skyrim is your best bet.
I still have a lot to do in the world of Skyrim. Go get this game, and you'll know why this game is addicting. This is Tim Kong, and I give this game a 10 out of 10 criminal scums. Remember, try not to lose the game.
Marching Band and Color Guard have been busy these past few weeks with competitions. Like always, they brought home all the top awards. Here's Sarah to tell us more.
Hey guys! Every year, Arcadia High School's Marching Band and Color Guard has done us proud by always bringing home the top awards. And this year is no different. Band started off the season placing first in Roland and took sweeps at Riverside King, Mount Carmel, and Chino.
Aw, yeah. However, the most fulfilling part of band isn't the awards.
I think the most fulfilling part is watching the growth of the individual student. Students come every year and they have very little experience, yet by the end of the year, it's hard to tell the new inexperienced students from the veterans.
There's quite a bit of pressure because I'm the most visible representative of our band, so a lot of people's eyes are on me. And it's definitely an honor, though. It's nerve-wracking at times, but it's one of the most fulfilling things I've ever taken on.
So thanks, you band people, for always bringing us a great show and some great music. Back to you guys in the studio.
Thanks, Sarah. Remember to come out and support Arcadia tomorrow at Arcadia Festival of the Bands on Baldwin and Duarte Road, starting at 8:40 a.m. See you guys there.
Diversity Week this year is on the week of December 5th through the 9th. If any clubs are interested in participating, please email asb@ausd.net. If you wish to perform during lunch, the deadline to send a video of your performance has been extended to November 28th, so don't forget.
Are you craving some yummy CPK? Well, we'll be hosting a fundraiser on November 22nd from 11 a.m. to 9:30 p.m. at the California Pizza Kitchen in the Westfield Mall. The money raised will benefit the California Home for the Adult Deaf. Hey, Brittany.
Huh? What does that mean?
How do you not know what that means?
Oh. It's time for sports.
What are you?
Agile Hostile Mobile!
What is pain?
French bread!
Will you ever quit?
No! We want some more! We want some more! We want some more!
Girls volleyball destroyed the competition this season. They grabbed every school and basically just... Here's Clay to tell you more.
Last Tuesday, girls volleyball went to CIF playoffs. Let's see how they did. Here's Catherine Sue with a kill. And Lexi Resch with another kill. And Brittany Lee with another kill. And Dakota Bundesman with another kill. Arcadia beats Rio Mesa 3-0. The girls also had a CIF game on Thursday, but lost 3-0 against Diamond Bar. Arcadia's league record was 10 wins and 2 losses. Good job, girls. Way to have a great season. Back to you, Jeff.
Have you seen the path of the destroyed schools like Pasadena and CV? Well, if you have, then they're the schools that Arcadia Boys football has destroyed. Here's James A.G. to tell you more about their rampage.
Arcadia football has been destroying their opponents, pounding Pasadena, and crushing CV.
Marta Mooney intercepts the ricochet off of Pasadena's receiver and takes it down 35 yards. Jake Mandel utilizes a screen and takes the ball down to the 50, the 40, the 30, all the way down to the 1 yard line. Zan the Landshark attacks his prey without hesitation. Their quarterback wasn't running the ball after that hit. Joey Willem, you're superb. Alex McElwee, how did you catch that ball?
Arcadia, CIF versus Bonita High. Here tonight at 7. Be there. This has been James A.G. reporting. Back to you guys.
Boys Cross Country is making Amar Musa proud. They've gone 14-0, and here's Steven Chu for more.
Recently, our very own Boys Cross Country team placed first overall in league, qualified for CIF, and hopefully state meet.
This season, we only have one goal, pretty much, and that is to repeat our state championship. And by doing that, we'll qualify on it next in, and we'll see if we got a shot at national champions again.
To tell you the truth, it's really, really, really hard work. And besides the fact that I'm also doing another extracurricular activity. But yeah, coach makes us train really, really hard. And, you know, there's no doubt about that. That's why we're the best of the best.
Remember to show our boys as they try to run to repeat as national champions. That's all we have on cross country. Back to you guys.
Girls golf has been trailblazing it through the golf courses, through the schools, through the competition, and even through the golf balls. They finished their season 19-1. Who's that one? We don't know. They're also CIF finalists. Did you get goosebumps? Because I did.
Apache Sports Team, delivering sports, celebrating the first Thanksgiving.
Sports team has really stepped it up. Oh, and speaking of steps, the drama department's last performances of the play, The 39 Steps, are tonight and tomorrow night at 7 p.m. Don't forget to go watch.
Hey seniors, from November 28th through December 2nd, Senior Council will be pre-selling See's Candies, so find a member of Senior Council to see what types of delectable chocolates are for sale. Also, FIDM College will be visiting on Tuesday, November 29th at lunch in the Career Center.
Hey, has anyone told Andy that the lockdown's over?
Has anyone ever found Andy?
Get me out of here. Get me out of here. Get me out of here. It's looking at the bottom.